from the KATC Weatherland. Here's Rob's forecast.
Welcome back. Well, the heat goes on, and it's going to stay with us for at least four or five more days, up until about Tuesday, Wednesday of next week. Now, we're not going to see a cool front. We're just going to see temperatures getting back into the mid-90s versus the upper 90s as we get into next week, but we'll add rain chances as well. So let's take a look at that upper-level pattern as we look at about 18,000 feet, also known as the 500 millibar level in weather jargon, and that high pressure ridge has not changed a whole lot. Now, just because you have this ridge and it's pretty dry ridge doesn't mean you can't have thunderstorms. You see a little bit of a thunderstorm complex here in Mexico, another one here by the Texas Hill Country, and more action to the north. But more than likely, the storm track for afternoon showers and storms stays just away from us. It's going to be a close call in the days ahead. We'll see some thunderstorm activity close by, but most of Acadiana staying dry and only getting hotter. So as we take a look at the regional Doppler radars and some of the cloud cover, you see tornado watches back to the west, a moderate risk of severe weather up here by Oklahoma. So storm chasers are up there for sure. All the sweeps across Louisiana relatively quiet. Severe thunderstorm watch for our friends in the Florida Panhandle. Strong to severe storms out here. And for our friends at the local beaches from Panama City on westward, the threat of thunderstorms once again this evening. They'll be dropping slowly to the south and east. Lower chances as you get to Pensacola Gulf Shores, but nonetheless some storms for our friends out over there who are watching us on the app, on KATC.com, on the phone app. You have so many ways to watch us even when you're away from home. Now locally, Power Doppler 3, a clean sweep once again. Not a whole lot going on locally. So we'll take a look at the tropics. In fact, I haven't done a tropical update yet so far this year, but this one garners the first update. Nothing going on in the Gulf nor the Caribbean at this point, but the National Hurricane Center identifying a disturbance that's going to come off the African coastline as a low chance of development, 20% over the next 7 days. So we'll keep an eye on it. This is an unusual spot for any tropical activity this time of year because water temperatures usually don't support tropical activity, but the Atlantic is as warm as it's ever been on record going back over the last 40 years. Here's the Euro model picking up on that disturbance as it rolls across the Atlantic. This is getting into mid next week, so something organized could approach the eastern, northeastern Caribbean thereafter. Forecast is a little nebulous as we go 10 days down the road, but what we do notice is blobs of deeper tropical moisture starting to parade across the Atlantic, starting to come out of Central America. So tropical season not too far away, but this gets us almost to the end of June. I don't see big significant rain chances and probably until sometime in July, but we do have better rain chances in the forecast down the line. It's not going to be what cures the ill of our dry weather. And again, you can see strong storms bypassing us to the north through daybreak tomorrow. Temperatures near record lows for tonight, then tomorrow back up to 97, perhaps 98 degrees at heat index well over 100. And as we head into tomorrow night, Saturday morning, much the same, near 80, partly cloudy skies. And Saturday afternoon, storms miss us once again here in Acadiana. So overnight tonight, upper 70s, northern portions of Acadiana, lower 80s elsewhere. And then tomorrow afternoon, mid to upper 90s with that heat index exceeding 110. That's kind of rare. We don't see that every summer. Usually we're in the 105 to 108 range in any typical summer. A few years here and there, it's 110, 112, 115, 116. If we see that deeper into the weekend, that will be near records. And notice, 80 degrees for your Saturday morning, but that heat index never goes below 90, and the heat index up to 112 or hotter for Saturday afternoon. That's why we have that excessive heat watch in the forecast. Heat indices across the area, highest right along the I-10 corridor, a little bit better down by the coast, but not by much. And you can see much of the area is going to be between about 105 and 112 over the next several days. So again, stay hydrated, get indoors, get into the air conditioned environment. And again, your heat index above 100 today was above 100. It was 102 at 8:30 today. So you can see the prime time for those high heat indices. And it really doesn't doesn't improve until about 9 o'clock at night. So overnight tonight, we'll go 80 the low. The record is 80 back in 1917. So if we hit 81, we'll break that record. If not, we're likely tied. And then for tomorrow, heat index 106 to 112 with a high of about 97 to 98 degrees. At least a nice tropical breeze continues. We've had that over the last several days. So we'll take that and run upper 90s as we go through next week. And then we do introduce some rain chances as we get into the mid and latter part of next week, cooling us off into the almost refreshing mid-90s and lows getting down into the mid to upper 70s. Still 3 to 5 degrees above normal.
It's going to feel refreshing, though.
It really is.
5 degrees makes a big difference.
Uh-huh. It does.
98, 99, or 93 or 4.
Looking forward to it. All right. Thanks, Rob.